Hi, I'm Dr. Giant. Thanks for joining me for Raji's quick clip. I was asked today by a viewer, who do you consider to be a good Sculptra aesthetic patient? I thought that was a great question. We'll do it in a quick clip. Let's get started in 3 seconds. So a great question, Sculptra aesthetic. It's one of the most versatile products that I use. Not a lot of people do it. It's something you do more and more over time as you gain confidence with, but there's several things that you should not do, in my opinion, for my practice, for my patients, with Sculptra. So it's one of those things that you got to get into the routine of using. If it's around, you'll use it all the time. Who is a great candidate? There's so many people and so many circumstances where I use it. Now I'm talking face, body's a whole nother video we'll do, but if you're talking about the face, patients in general, let's talk with the number one. Well, there'll probably be 3 or 4 different types of patients. The number one is it's a collagen builder, much more so than what most people get with hyaluronic acid. So if I see a person who's lost collagen, who has lines and folds and wrinkles, doesn't matter the age, rarely do I see that before 30 for the most part, but after 30, it could be 30, 40, could be 50, typically 40s, but it's commonly now in the 30s. As you see collagen loss, we're much more preventive. So that's what I would say. And you know, you guys know, you walk around, you see the streets, you go have dinner with your friends, you're seeing collagen loss, look for it early. It's a little sag, it's little lines, it's crow's feet. It's all the little things. Vertical lip lines is a late sign of collagen loss, even though it can occur in a 25, 35 year old. When you're seeing vertical lip lines, that's telling you something, and consider hormonal issues too. Okay, so if we take a Sculptra patient here before, okay, and we look and we see, I want you to pay attention, and we're gonna do a whole video on this, but lower face. Lower facial aging is something that is very apparent, and it's the first place or area on the face that's going to age a person between 40 and 50. You can see the upper face is somewhat preserved. But if you look at the before picture, which is here, note that we have 18 weeks after the treatment in this picture here. 18 weeks, she might not even see that difference. But if we come over to 27 weeks, look at the rejuvenation. Now, things were done throughout the facial region and the upper face as well. But I want you to look at the before and look at the after. Yes, great things take a bit of time, but this picture here just shows a more youthful look. If you go to the pictures below, again, look at the before, we're at 18 weeks, and then 27 weeks, and you can see the jawline isn't particularly changed. It isn't like it's not herself, but have a look, and you just take this picture, then you take this one, and now you come to the final, which would you rather? So we're going to talk about money in this video a little bit, but I wanted you to see a before and after, and this here in the pre-pictures really represents what? It's collagen loss. Collagen loss, okay, and then we get collagen back up here. If we look at how this works, and this is really important because we went through profilo, hyaluronic acids, but here, look at this. This pink, the little pink molecules represent the collagen. You see this fibroblast cell moving in here. Okay, that's going to reproduce collagen. Those white strands are your collagen. The PLLA, or the Sculptra, which is in kind of the pink looking little balls, they're building this collagen by way of the fibroblasts. As we age, we don't produce as many fibroblasts, as much collagen. And there's, if you want to really geek out into this, look at MMPs, matrix metalloproteins, and collagenases. But you see the structure improving, you see more collagen in the skin. What does this show? If you look at the top of the skin and you look at as it rises, as the collagen and the elastin builds, that's what we're looking for. So that's, it's a big collagen stimulator. By big, what do I mean? Powerful, predictable, but it's also why you have to be judicious. Use it as it should be, and don't use too much at one sitting. Don't do too many
sessions initially, you need patience, and patience is the patient. And that's the second thing. A client who gets Sculptra should have some degree of tolerance to look at the results over time. They want something for tomorrow night. Well, they'll get the volume that you put in with the Sculptra in the water, okay? But they're not going to get their final result for about 6 months. Those are the best results, things that occur over time. A practitioner that looks at your face, we're talking faces today, and says, hey, this is what I think we should do over the next 6 months to a year for your long-term plan. You know you're in the right spot. Okay, so someone who's losing collagen, someone who has some patience. The next category I use it in is if I'm seeing sliding of the face. Now, it's a misnomer. Face doesn't just slide alone or droop, although we see that as an end result. But it helps hold things up. A lot of the injections we do are what we call periosteal, especially in the upper face. So it helps with those, in my opinion, when you use it in those patients, we don't see them get the droop and the slide that they were getting. A lot of times that's skin type 4 and above, that's darker skin types. I start them a little earlier, more towards the 30s. Another great candidate for Sculptra.
Okay, so we can see a progression here from a youthful face to maybe a middle-aged face, and we'll call this older. You can see this is nice jawline, the skin looks good, there's not a lot of crow's feet. I talked about that collagen. This is a sign of collagen loss. Vertical lip lines, this person doesn't have. There is somewhat of a genetic component, and also, of course, dentition plays a role in whether people get those. But this here is definitely a sign of early collagen loss. As with these lines, the downturn of the mouth or the RBF, this is what's driving people to come into our practice. So starting early with something like Sculptra helps prevent this from happening. And of course, this is a facelift stage. So a lot of people saying, what do I get? Could you improve it? Certainly. Could you help improve this? Could you do a little lip filler after you do everything? This vertical or horizontal crease in the eye, very, very difficult to treat. But understanding, if you come in at this age over here, it's way different than coming somewhere in the middle here before this happens. Okay, so that's the big difference. And that's why we're trying to talk about prevention, sunscreen, wearing sunglasses, and preventing the collagen loss, because it's harder to then get it back. Okay, so when I'm talking about sagging and periosteal injections, and when you looked at that collagen production, it's not just producing the collagen, but creating that state where the skin does not sag, where this does not happen. Very difficult. And when we start to treat this, of course, what are people going to want to do when you come in the middle picture? Okay, most people are going to say right here, let's fill that. If you fill this area, you're going to widen the lower jaw. And now you have ptosis of the cheek and you have all the collagen loss. It's somewhat the same reason why I say we're not, if we just use filler and a little bit of lip filler, we haven't made this person younger. You have to blanket the entire face with collagen production for them to actually look youthful. And that's really the limitation of hyaluronic acid dermal fillers.
The other good candidate is someone where it would be too expensive to use hyaluronic acid fillers. That's someone that needs the preauricular filled. They need panfacial volume.
Now imagine, take Mick here, and imagine, of course, we see a youthful face here. And you can kind of see where the aging is going to occur. You can see the hollows, even though he looked great and he was young. And you can see what might be preserved, his lips and lip area. Okay, but if you look at the picture over here and you say, hey, this person's coming in for filler, where would you start? Imagine putting in cheek filler here. Imagine starting in the jawline. Yes, there's loose skin. You can make them look younger with Sculptra, but our job as injectors is to look forward to say, hey, what can we prevent and what can we do? This would be what I would call definitely a dermal filler failure over here, because we wouldn't know where to go. And you just adding a gel filler, similarly to why I don't use gel fillers in the temple, you're going to get a line of demarcation. It's not going to last. It will break the bank. And this person needs collagen stimulation, like I said before, everywhere. There's not, funny enough, a lot of sun damage in that video. So actually, he's a pretty good Sculptra candidate. But I remember, looking through here, you can see, well, the lips will probably be preserved. And at his age, certainly they were. Not a big nasal labial fold. Why? There's not a lot of facial fat. There's really not a lot of descent or sag in his after picture either. But certainly you can see where fillers would fail here. Everyone asks, of course, about hooding of the eyes. It's going to be very hard, even if you fill the temple and you take neuromodulators to lift that eye, which is what people want. And imagine the how deep the lines are in his glabella here. That would be something hard to fix with neuromodulators. But you can see this is pan facial volume loss. Where else might you get that? Right here. I'm going to spell it out for you. Runners. So when you see, when I see my runner friends, they look 10, 15 years older. Okay, they need full facial treatment. And they can be young. They can be 40 to 50. And they look like Mick does over here because they lost all their facial volume. HIV lipoatrophy was caused by the drugs that were given initially to treat HIV, and they created that facial wasting. There's a stigma with that. And so that's where Sculptra really originated from. And then, of course, we have the aesthetic indication. And that was in the US in 2009, but it was in around 96 in Europe. So it started coming to USA at that time.
And your homework video for this is going to be watching the video I did on Look 10 Years Younger, where we address the whole face. I use my plasma sculpt, which is platelet-rich fiber and Sculptra. Because remember, people don't want half their face done or a quarter of their face. The only reason they're doing it is if it's financial reasons, if their provider doesn't have the product or it wasn't recommended to them, because people have a choice where they spend their time, energy, and money. And if they know what can be achieved by their provider, then you'll find out, you'll see, they will allocate funds from other optional things they were purchasing and put it towards their face, because it's often more important and more often seen than their car, their house, their kitchen, their rims, their tires, everything else. But people treating half the face just never makes sense to me. So watch the video and Look 10 Years Younger. You can see top to bottom what I do, how I address it. Sculptra's very particular. There's a lot of things you should not do with it. This is a quick clip. Let me know what questions you have from this. And remember, your homework is to watch my video on Look 10 Years Younger without surgery. And I put a link in the description below. And I also put a card at the end of this video so you can click and watch it. Thanks for joining me. Join me on the next Raji's Quick Clip. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.